Touch gloves?
Yes, sir.
Okay, back your corners.
Wiratchai versus Khan is brought to you by LG Electronics Singapore, the leader in TV technology that brings you the award-winning OLED TV that delivers exceptional picture quality with perfect black.
Okay, fight!
And here we go. Amir Khan coming out aggressive with the right kicks.
Three kicks in all. Good start from him. There's the fourth, going upstairs with it. Nothing coming from Wiratchai so far. It's all Amir Khan. Spurred on by his home crowd here. Really absolutely packed house here. Great atmosphere in Singapore. Perhaps the best atmosphere we've had in this stadium where it all began.
Shan's getting a little bit flat-footed, not really moving around. Amir Khan is just picking his shots with that right kick.
Oh, Shannon tried to just hold that foot and tried to cuff him with the right hand. Didn't quite set it up perfectly, though. Right hand there from Amir.
He's rushing him. I like Amir's strategy here. Moving forward, using his dominant size. Shannon just kind of shaking it off. That usually means he got him a bit.
Ooh. Tremendous balance, isn't he, Amir?
Okay.
A little bit low, a little bit low.
Time.
Shannon realizing a mistake, just kind of shaking it off. Amir definitely has a strategy going with that right kick to that left side. You can see when one fighter is right, one fighter is left, it opens up that side of the body. And Amir Khan is taking full advantage of it.
That was a real mixed martial arts combination from Wiratchai. Punch, punch, elbow, elbow.
Shannon's got to be a little bit more aggressive. He's just kind of waiting for Amir Khan to attack and then strike back. I'd like to see Shannon initiate some combinations here.
Yep, it's all Amir at the moment in terms of initiating attacks, isn't it? And he likes that kick. He's got great balance, especially when he brings that right leg up very high. His stability on that left leg of his is tremendously solid.
But I don't think Shannon can keep eating those right kicks from Amir.
I tell you what though, Shannon is coming back with good left hands and they're scoring too. There's a good right from Amir.
Tried to catch an answer. Amir's got to be careful with that inside right kick he's throwing. Yup, he's trying to catch it. Ooh, he's catching him. Nice. Uh-oh, here comes that clinch of Amir. Shannon's got the underhook there. Amir's got to try to spin away from the cage so he can get his hips into some of those knees.
Nice work, 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 work.
That's it. Shannon's so strong up against that cage.
What a nice little short left hand that is. Sort of hook, uppercut from Wiratchai with Amir pressed up against the cage. It's a good action-packed first 3 minutes that we've seen.
Shannon's dropping his hands a little bit. We got to keep those hands up, especially with a striker with the capability of Amir Khan.
How is Amir Khan on the floor, Mitch? Is it perhaps in his thoughts to get down onto the mat and take advantage?
I definitely think so, but Shannon has really good takedown defense. You know, he learned a lot from our first fight where I was controlling the ground position. So in the second fight, his ground defense was so much better. He's really evolved and he's added that element to his game. So Amir Khan might be trying to wear him down in the later rounds, take it to the ground.
These two are unleashing. It's a very intriguing and enthralling stand-up contest so far, directly above us here at cage side. Wiratchai with his back against the cage.
See, now Khan has his hips. Now he can start using his hips to throw those knees. And those elbows, that's where he likes it. Ooh, turn him with the elbow.
Ooh, it was the elbow that caught Wiratchai. And he's rocked a little bit, isn't he?
Yeah, I think Wiratchai is a little bit dazed. It's smart to go to the clinch. Amir should push away and start striking again.
Took a few steps back to just solidify his stance on the cage there and then clinch, as you said, Mitch.
We're in that final minute of the first round here.
Be interested to get Rich Franklin's view on who's got the better of this first 5 minutes, because it's all been in the stand-up and they're both very talented in that area. The aggressor certainly is Amir Khan.
Yeah, he is moving forward. He's got a good strategy by attacking the open side of Wiratchai's body. And now he's just got him up against the cage. You know, Shannon's been focusing on the TV thing. I don't know if he's really put in the work that Amir has. Amir's been fighting regularly, trying to get as much work as he can before he goes to national service. I don't know if Shannon's going to have the gas tank
seconds,
to
guys.
Keep up with Khan.
Oh, good right hand.
I like
from
that
Shannon.
Hook of his. It is catching him, too.
There it is, another left. Oh, on another one. And oh, that really did catch Amir Khan 2 seconds before the bell rang. He got his own bell rung, didn't he, Amir Khan? Having probably had the better of that first 5 minutes. He just got a little waking up call in the final few moments. Mitch, let's take a look at your stats, first of all, from... Rich, I should say. Beg your pardon, your stats from that first 5 minutes.
Well, this is a perfect example of how a fight should actually progress. Amir came out very aggressive.
Both of these guys, this is a pretty even match, actually.
I have Amir ahead on the damage inflicted as well as the striking superiority, just inching this fight out. But at this point in time, this is anybody's fight, and I really like what Wiratchai was doing right there at the end of the round. He was really starting to gain some momentum, so we'll see if he can continue that into the next phase of the fight.
Oh, he caught it beautifully in the final few seconds there. It's a real thriller, this one. First 5 minutes down. And it's amazing, really, 4 or 5 years ago, there wasn't anybody to speak of in the Singapore scene in mixed martial arts who was tearing things up. Now, you can point to a number of people, and Amir Khan is certainly one of those guys, got a great work ethic. Is trying to arrange his national service such that he can continue to train and fight. And it'll be a pleasure to watch him do that.
I like how he keeps attacking that right lead leg of Wiratchai, trying to slow Wiratchai down. Take away some of that explosiveness, especially that right hook that Wiratchai does so well. See if Khan can put together some combinations. Wiratchai stalking forward. Yeah, Steve, you're right. The Singaporean MMA scene has just exploded. And it is very evident here tonight at this packed Singapore indoor stadium. This crowd is electrified right now by their hometown boy, Amir Khan.
We saw something like that in the first round. Amir getting his kick caught and then taking one on the chin. So watch out for that.
See, Shannon's being a little bit more aggressive in moving forward in this fight. So there's a little bit of blood there. It looks like it's coming from the left eye
of Amir Khan, just up there in the corner. Above the eye. I don't think the blood's going to run into the eye, which is the problem with cuts on and around the eyebrow. It looks as if it's going to run down the side of the face. So that's one advantage.
See, Shannon understands what Amir does well with the clinch. He's defending it very well, smiles at him.
Often when a fighter realizes he's cut, he steps up his game just a little bit. And I think we saw that from Amir. It's a little flurry, the intensity of which we haven't seen.
Yeah, there's always in the back of your mind that something like a cut can stop the fight, so you have to increase the intensity even more to make sure that the fight isn't stopped. And it's not affecting you. Nice right hand by Amir Khan.
And it was acknowledged by Shannon as well. It was right on the button, wasn't it? Pushed his head back, straight right hand.
Guys, action!
That guard of Shannon, not as high as his opponent's, and he's vulnerable to a quick, snappy right hand like that.
Yeah, Wiratchai does not come from the strict Muay Thai background that most of the Thai fighters do. He comes from a judo background. He likes the unorthodox striking style, but he does have power.
Loving these single punches from Amir. He took a great elbow from Shannon there. Hardly seemed to faze him.
That was beautifully executed. He ducked under the punch and threw that elbow. That is a very highly, highly skilled Muay Thai technique.
Incredible timing to do that.
As I just say, he's not a Muay Thai efficient. He throws one of the classic Muay Thai elbows. Shannon loves making me look bad.
I know, when are you getting a complex, Mitch?
Oh, man, I already have one. But I am enjoying this contest here tonight.
Well, Amir said part of his incentive to do well tonight.
Nice elbows by Wiratchai, landed in the clinch up against the cage.
Part of his incentive is to get revenge for you, but it's a struggle, isn't it? exposed are you when you catch a kick just like that, Mitch? Because both of your hands are busy, aren't they? So you can't defend your face.
But he's actually catching with one hand, and so it's actually highly technical to, you know, deliver punches and strikes. It looks like Shannon's trying to catch the kick, throw the kick, and land a strike at the same time. But Amir is striking immediately after getting caught.
Oh, this is a cracking fight. Both men giving and receiving punches. It's really a thrill for the fans here. They're on their feet and applauding. 1 minute left in the second round, and the entertainment value is high.
Oh,
there's a takedown.
Scores a nice takedown in the final minute of the second round.
How significant will that be when we reach the 10-minute mark with five to go?
We'll have to get Rich Franklin here to chime in on that to see how if that swayed the fight so far.
Oh, what a lot of punches. Don't forget, Amir's got a cut above his left eye, so those punches won't do him any good, although they landed pretty much on the right-hand side of his head.
Those punches aren't going to do much damage, except that he has that cut, and that's the only difference maker. It's kind of annoying to be hit from that position. You can see him trying to stretch out the arm to hook it under his legs, but Shannon's defending really well.
Oh,
so
he's done it,
gets it.
Oh,
and he rolls out.
He rolled around.
Very good ground game.
What a cracking contest. Final 10 seconds. Stick around, everyone. We've got five more minutes of this.
Amir controlling Wiratchai up against the cage, and Shannon kind of saying he has nothing.
At the 10-minute mark, it is looking more and more like the judges will be called upon to give us their decision about who's won this fight. Let's go to a man.
Oh,
that was the
right. That's the elbow.
That was the elbow, wasn't it?
That was beautiful.
What impact did that have on your scoring, Rich Franklin?
Wow, let me tell you, this fight, this could be anybody's fight right now. I have these guys dead even on damage inflicted. I have these guys dead even on striking superiority. Obviously, Amir, towards the end of the round there, was able to score the takedown. He was able to control Wiratchai there for about 60 seconds on the ground. So that's going to put him ahead on the scorecards as far as I'm concerned at this point in time.
Mitch, not easy to score properly when you're commentating. I appreciate that. But who would you have ahead at this stage?
I gotta give the slight edge to Amir Khan, the way that he finished, you know, that final nine minute mark, how he got the takedown controlled from the ground. Wiratchai did pop up, but it's a very, very close fight, and this third round could be the decision maker.
Yeah, I think it could be. I think you're right. I also think that Amir is probably slightly ahead, but I think that Shannon is coming to the fore, and if I had to predict this final 5 minutes, it would probably go to Shannon. So let's see.
I questioned Shannon's gas tank in the beginning of this fight, but it doesn't look like that's a problem at all. Attempts the front kick.
He had a little grab at it again, didn't he, Shannon? He likes to hold that kick and see what he can achieve while his man's on one leg.
But Amir seems to be defending that very well, very comfortable. Like the high guard of Amir, keeping his face protected.
Yeah, he does a good job there, but he ate a cracking right hand to the jaw.
That was beautiful. He pawed the hand down and came, slipped right over with that right jab.
Took a nice left hand inside there as well, Amir.
I would like to see Amir use some wrestling right now and possibly take this fight to the ground.
Work.
But Shannon spins him around. He used that underhook to get him around. Once you have that underhook, that arm under Amir's left arm, he has much better control of him. Amir's trying to use the hand to control position.
Break.
Yeah, that was a stalemate. And Joey LePete did a very good job to bring him back to the center of the cage. Oh. Amir Khan going to work. Throws more punches.
Moving forward. Shannon's not backing down. He's coming forward too.
Still the busier of the two. Shannon throws impressive one-punch shots. Eye-catching, certainly scoring with the judges, but Amir is busier, and that counts for an awful lot.
The crowd here is getting behind their Singaporean and trying to urge him on to victory to give him that little bit extra push.
Well, if we're all correct, and Amir Khan was ahead at the 10-minute mark, we're now at the 12-minute mark, and there are 3 minutes left for Shannon to make up that ground, if indeed He is in deficit.
I would like to see one of the fighters come away with a big combination, get away from the clinch. Not much is going on there. They got to push. They got to try to excel. They've got to try to go for the win here.
And this is where it gets tough, isn't it? The cardio starts to hurt. The final 3 minutes. Good work from Shannon Wiratchai. Not for the first time, gives his opponent a little nod. The elbow again. That's the second time he's done that, having ducked under a punch. The counter elbow. Short little choppy right hand from Shannon Wiratchai.
They're both trying to pick up the pace here. They understand how important this fight is.
Did we see the first sign of fatigue there from Amir Khan? It was a bit of a sloppy punch that he threw, and he got punished for it.
And he's moving backwards now. You're seeing the game start to shift. It's starting to change. If Shannon can make a big final push here in the final 2 minutes. Ooh, big head kick just missed.
To me, Shannon looks as if he's just got a little bit more left in the tank, but has he got enough time to utilize it?
I like how Shannon's using the elbows up against the cage there against Khan. There's the takedown that I was talking about, but Shannon stuffs it. His takedown defense is so good, especially up against the cage.
We knew that cage was there. All he had to do was try and bring them both a couple of paces back. 1.5 minutes left in the final round. This one will be a close one. It's been a thriller to watch.
Guys, action.
It's been exhausting to take part in, I'm sure. The cut doesn't seem to have been a factor.
See, he's landing those sneaky elbows up against the cage. That's a new element to Wiratchai's game. I really like it. Ooh, see, there it is again.
Great elbow. He's done so well with that in this fight. Wiratchai.
Rich, what do you think is going to happen here in the last minute? How do you think this guy's going to get scored? It's definitely going to leave a lasting impression in the judge's eyes. I think that could have been the nail in the coffin.
It could just give him the edge, couldn't it?
He's landing vicious ground and pound. The crowd is exploding.
They're really getting behind him as these right hand punches come down. These are the final seconds where if it's close, it could make the difference. The takedown, the industry that he showed, the solid first 10 minutes that he had. Shannon came back well in this final round, but this could be the difference maker. Final 5 seconds now. Amir Khan, if he can keep busy, could just nick it. The fight ends with Wiratchai on his back. Amir Khan throwing down the punches, and you can see how much the crowd appreciated that one.
What a battle.
This one means a lot to you, Mitch. Twice in the cage with Shannon Wiratchai, a longtime colleague of Amir Khan. I'm going to ask you who you thought won.
I don't know. I mean, Shannon really turned it on in that, you know, at that 8 minute mark and kind of pushed through. But then you see Amir Khan landing the final takedown. And oh, I do not envy the judges here.
Rich Franklin, we don't envy the judges, but we're still going to ask you who you thought won.
Oh, Lord. Let me tell you, this is a close, close fight. We're going to see what the judges come up with here. The telltale here is the striking superiority. Wiratchai actually started really doing some damage like right around the 12 to 13 minute mark of the fight. He started running away with it, and as far as the striking superiority and the damage. The takedown from Amir, although it's going to help him score on the cards, what he did with it afterwards, he controlled the next 60 to 90 seconds of the fight, but he really didn't do any more damage to Wiratchai. So on my scorecards, I think Wiratchai did enough to actually take the decision there. We'll see what the judges think.
I've changed my mind twice. I'm going with Amir Khan.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one says, Wiratchai. Judge number two, Khan. And judge number three, for your winner, via split decision, Shannon Wiratchai!